गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वील स्टार्ट विद हिस्ट्री। वील स्टार्ट विद व्हाट, वेयर एंड हाउ। सो आवर लाइफ कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू डिफरेंट फेजेस, चाइल्डहुड, टीनेज, यूथ, मिडिल एज एंड ओल्ड एज। एज वी मूव फ्रॉम वन फेज टू अनदर, many changes take place in our bodies, personality, roles and responsibility. For example, we grow taller when we join a college to pursue higher studies, we go to office to work and so on. So when the society as a whole undergoes major changes, a new phase in history begins. Many historians divided history into three phases: ancient history, medieval history and modern history. The span of these phases differ from one region to another, as the onset of the changes may vary from place to place. So in this chapter we will explore the medieval history of India. So the medieval period of India extends from 8th up to the 18th century. And historian divided this period roughly into two sub-phases: early medieval period 700 to 1200 century and late medieval period 1200 to 1700 century. So first we talk about cartographer and Indian history. So historians often refer to maps to gather information about history. Cartographer in the olden times made maps based on the account of traveler and sailors. Traveler wrote accounts of their journey and the route they followed. On the basis of this information, cartographers prepared map on the Indian subcontinent and the surrounding regions. So look at these two maps. Let us compare to medieval map of the Indian subcontinent, one prepared by Arab cartographer Muhammad al-Dirisi and another by a French cartographer named D. Isle. Okay. Map 1.1 shows a part of the world map prepared by Muhammad al-Dirisi in 1154 century. He made the map on the basis of the information that was shared by the traveler and trader of his times, who had traveled to India through the Arabian Sea. The map appears upside down as it is oriented toward the south, India, that is in the south, and Sri Lanka is the island at the top. And look at this map. In the 1720s, a French cartographer, Isle, made a map of India and showed several places in the Indian subcontinent, particularly the coastline, with great accuracy. So this map gave the detailed information . So the two maps are quite different in appearance, even though they represent the same geographical area in a span of about 600 years. The information provided by the traveler to the cartographers improved, which we can observe from the difference between the two maps. Therefore, historian refers to ancient texts, documents and maps to know about the changes that took place between the two time periods. For example, by referring to both the map, historian can tell about the evaluation of map making and information about sea journey that help cartographer in their work. So next topic, we have various names of the Indian subcontinents. So just as maps, the name of Indian subcontinent have also changed over a period of time. In the ancient period, the Indian subcontinent was referred to by different names. The people who inhabited the northern part of the subcontinent called themselves Aryans. Therefore, the region was named Aryavrata. Okay. So the word Bharatvarsha was used for the region north of ocean and south of Himalayas. द साउथ एशिया वर ऑल्सो नोन एज द लैंड ऑफ वुड एप्पल ट्री एंड देयर फॉर कॉल्ड जम्बू द्वीपा एंड अनदर नेम फॉर इंडिया वॉज सप्त सिंधु मीनिंग द लैंड ऑफ सेवन रिवर एंड द एंशियंट ग्रीक कॉल्ड इट इंडोई विच मीन्स पीपल ऑफ द इंडस. The Indus River or Sindhu and its five tributaries flow through the northwestern part of India. When the Iranian and Arab came to India, they mispronounced it as Hindu. The term Hindustan was popularized by the book Kitab al-Hind, written by the Arab traveler al-Biruni. However, during Biruni's period, the term was used mainly to refer to the territory situated in the northernmost part of the India. In Tabaqat e Nasiri, a chronicle named Minaj-e-Siraj, used the term Hindustan for Punjab, Haryana, and the region of Ganga and Doab. And Amir Khusro, a 13th century mystic Sufi poet, and the term Hind merely as an expression of for geographical and culture unity. Thank you.